YouTubers. So yes, I'm wearing my "I'm ashamed of what I did for a Klondike bar" shirt. Yeah, you're not reading the shirt wrong. Anyways, I wanted to talk to you about a very good video that I got to see today, and that was from Hugh Jeffery's. I've always watched Hugh Jeffery's videos. I've always enjoyed his videos. They're always fabulous, always fun. When he's repairing like iPhones and other cool things that he's done. This is kind of cool. He did an Apple Cinema Display video entitled "A Tech Product Like No Other Apple Cinema Display." There's some cool things and some negative things I want to share with you, Hugh. I love your videos. I'm not ripping your video a new butthole in this by any means. But this is kind of where they kind of saw you coming with the cost of that display. Apple cheapened the Apple Cinema displays as they tried to shrink them down and make them more cost-effective and affordable. The reason why I like the 30-inch model, the original Apple Cinema display with DVI, which is what I have, is because the clarity of the screen is there. And I mean crisp, clean clarity. If you could see one of these in person, you would kind of see why this is one of my favorite displays to have and why I wanted one in my collection so badly. And there's another reason. They display at 2560 by 1600. And this is a 30-inch display. While the 27-inch USB model with DisplayPort and everything that Hugh was reviewing only displays at 2560 by 1440. You actually lose resolution when you go to the new monitors. And it's due to a firmware. They decided to not only cheapen the display itself, they decided to cheapen the display by adding a firmware lockout that limits your display resolution. This is why a lot of people do get rid of these Apple Cinema displays, and they're overpriced because of the fact of the matter being that they're not displaying in their full resolution and they're firmware locked. And so pretty much you're kind of SOL if you buy one. That's why I went with the DVI monitor versus an HDMI monitor, because I've got crisp clarity here. I've got beautiful clarity on my screen that is absolutely crisp and beautiful. And that's why I wanted the 30-inch display that I've got. And I admit, they saw you coming, dude, because let me tell you, I would not, in the remotest of hell, have paid $400 for that display. That display is not worth the $400. I'm sorry, dude. And it's not bad that you got it for that, because if you're not planning on using iTunes, enjoy it. They're not bad displays. But to firmware lock out somebody and to tell them, "Hi, here's a $2,000 monitor that doesn't do what it's supposed to do out of the box." Yeah. So, but good purchase, dude. Great video. Just wanted to give you props on that. But I wanted to just fill you in on a little bit of why people get rid of that monitor. It's kind of sad, too, because what Apple did, which really ticked people off with Apple Cinema displays, was they released the model that Hugh was reviewing, which is the 27-inch with USB-only ports. And then next year, they decided to release one with the FireWire, Thunderbolt, and USB all on one. And then they charged 3 times the price tag, but it's the same panel inside, and all they did was add a bunch of ports at the back and charged you more for the ports. Really stinks. Thank you. Have a wonderful day. I'll try to have a good day myself. I got a short work shift today, and we'll be doing some more streams coming up on Wednesday and Tuesday, hopefully. And I'll see you. Well, I don't know. Depends. If they change my schedule at work again, it'll be Wednesday and Thursday. See you later, ladies and gentlemen.